Hey, I'm Michael. Take a seat and join me for a game of the Pirate Republic by Greenfeet Games. Here is the game all set up. I'm going to be the blue ship, and plundering the Caribbean with me in cooperative game is going to be Rogue, of course, with the red ship here. And our flying gang mission here on behalf of forming the Pirate Republic is open seas. So we have to defeat two nations' navies, and I've drawn territory cards. And we've got Bath, which is England's navy, and Panuco, which is a Spanish navy, I believe. I don't really know the flags, but yeah, I think it's Spanish. But anyway, we've got to defeat those two navies. And for our pirate personas, Rogue will be Captain Sam Bellamy with the skull and crossbones here. And her captain mission to start is to make a pirate haven on Oracock. And that'll get her one swagger immediately, or two victory points at the end. And then with the fabled Jolly Roger flag here, I'm of course Calico Jack. And having determined randomly, I'm going to be starting the game. And my captain's mission, I should have said, is to be the first to reach level 4, which will get me 5 swagger or 10 victory points. So, start of my turn, first thing I do is draw my hand up to 4 cards, and it's already at 4 cards, so I don't draw anything. Then I have the option to form a gang if I was with Rogue, but we're apart, so we can't do that. So I roll the sailing dice, and I get a 2. So that means I have 5 movement. So, first thing I'm going to do is sail out to sea. Oh, and there's a pirate there. So, I'm going to be fighting this pirate. But we need to work out who has the initiative. So, we roll the initiative die. And it's a hit. So, I have the initiative. This means that I can now just run away if I want. Or I can attack. And I am going to attack. I'm going to use Try Again Matey to give me 2 ranged attack. And then Fire in the Hall with a reputation token to give me 5 total ranged attack. Which is more than the token's 4. So I kill it. And for doing so, I get 3 swagger. So 1, 2, 3. And I'm off the mark. And I get a new Chaos card, which being for me, actually goes to Rogue, and it replaces the existing one. The token then goes to the Enemies of the Pirate Republic section, and I carry on with my turn. And I've only used 1 movement, so I'm now going to use another one, because I spy this vulnerable looking merchant ship here, which only needs too close combat to defeat it, but first the initiative, and it's a hit again, so I'm okay on the initiative. And how am I going to do this? I will play Blow the Man Down, which gives me 1 ranged and 2 close, which is enough to defeat it. And this time I have a choice of rewards. So I think I'm going to go for the swagger, taking me up to 5. And the token joins the Enemies of the Pirate Republic. Then with my 4th bit of movement, I'm going to pop my head into St. Augustine here and see what we have. Oh, quite hard fought. So I'm going to use my final 5th movement to run away, because I don't want to be fighting that. And with my movement all gone, it's the end of my turn, so I draw back up. So I've still got 1 left, so I draw 3 more cards to take me back up to 4. And it's over to Rogue. Rogue already has four cards, so she rolls the sailing dice. And she gets the red lookout. But because she is on land, or she was before the dice smashed her away, she can ignore that result, so she is fine and safe with free movement. So she will move out to sea for one movement, then she will be fighting this merchant here. So initiative. Ooh, a critical miss. Ooh, so that's really bad. So she is actually going to use this card here with a reputation token to get a reroll and two close combat. And let's reroll. So we get a hit. So we can now attack. We've already got two close combat and we need a total of five. Or we could use this for ranged. So we use it for ranged and we need six. So we can, she can play this, which gets her two of each, and also a reputation token, taking her to four ranged, and then this will give her the six she needs to defeat it, giving her free swagger. And the token is a merchant, so it will go over here. And then she will... Wait. We have chaos! So this chaos card has triggered. If a pirate successfully attacks a merchant this round, say the following. Stop! This is the only trade where a pretty pirate can pick up a living. This merchant has rum for an entire town of Charlestown. You can pose as a merchant and successfully deliver the rum to receive your prize. You must enter the town undetected with successful initiative. If you decide not to deliver, you are immediately attacked by a random sea token. If you do deliver, receive additional reputation and any two played cards back in your hand. Now, unfortunately, Rogue can't actually manage to deliver. She doesn't have enough movement. So she will not be delivering, so she is immediately attacked. And what appears is a pirate. And it's a pirate she is not strong enough to beat right now after having just fought that merchant. But we have initiative. Will she be able to run away? She rolled a miss, so she cannot run away. Now, she could try and defend, but she only has one card in hand, and that is nowhere near enough to defend the five close combat. So she has a choice. She can choose to play this not-so-pirate's folly with a swagger token to get free close combat so that she's not being more than doubled on the attack, to avoid being captured and instead take a bloodshed token, or just be captured but not lose the reputation token. Well, she doesn't want to be captured, so she is going to play that with her reputation token, and she takes a bloodshed token. If she gets another bloodshed, she is captured. But this now means that she has the initiative, and she will run away. Is there a safe place for her to run to? So she's going to run away onto the land space. She still has one movement left, but she doesn't have any cards left in hand. So she is going to end her turn there, drawing four new cards as she has none in hand. And it's back to me. And I roll the sailing dice as I don't need to draw up. Oh, and we have scouted our first treasure ship. And given that I'm on the gold line, that's definitely the closest. So we follow the route back to its beginning in Havana, and we put two treasure ships there. And I'm going to start by playing Grog Before the Fog to draw a card, in the hope that that'll give me more useful things. But unfortunately, it hasn't. So I have free movement. I'm going to go one and fight this merchant here. So I need either four ranged or five close. But who is attacking? The initiative die says miss. Ooh. Well, I think my 13-gun salute has something to say about that. No, it really doesn't. Still a miss. But I need four close combat to avoid dying, and the 13-gun salute is giving me three close combat, so I need one more close to defend. I will use Cut 'em to Pieces to get one close. So that's my four close, so that's defended. Then, which means initiative's now with me, and I'm going to run away to Nassau, because I do not have the means to fight him now. And I'm going to end my turn there, so I need to draw up two cards, because I've only got two. And it's over to Rogue. So she doesn't need to draw, so we just roll the sailing die. She's got plus three movement. So six whole movement. But first, she's going to have to get away from where she is. So Rogue will sail out to meet this pirate who has her pinned down here. And initiative. Oh, a miss again. Okay, does she have a reroll? She does, but if she uses it, she won't be able to beat him anyway. Well, that's very frustrating, but she's going to have to use it, I think. So she'll use Try Again, Matey, to reroll. Oh, same, miss. Okay, so she needs to defend against five melee. Well, she actually can do that. She can do two melee for fire the ship, another two melee for blow the man down, and one melee plus draw a card, and may shuffle one discarded card back into your unplayed. So let's draw the card first, and then we shuffle a discarded card randomly picked here. So that's the card, and it's getting shuffled in then to her deck, and she now has the ability to run away or fight, but she is not strong enough to fight, so she will be running away, and she's just gonna run back into her little hole here. And she'll end her turn. She's got one card, so she draws three more. She's only got one left in her deck now, so we're near the end of round. So let's see what's happening for me, sailing. So treasure, but we ignore it because I'm on land, I'm in Nassau. So I will sail out to fight this merchant ship here. And is the initiative on my side? It is, I got a hit. So, I need four long range, or four close, or three surrender. Well, I can't do the surrender, and I can't do the close, so we'll go for four range, so that's two, three, four. Nice and simply done. Giving me two swagger, one, two, just shy of levelling there, and the token will join the others, so we're up to three out of six on the enemies of the Republic. Then I have two movement left, but only one card in hand, so I'm not confident of fighting anything, so I'm just going to pop back into Nassau to be safe. Then drawing back up, I need three cards, but I only have two, which means I need to draw a card and I can't, So it's the end of round. Now, I was first in the round, so Rogue has one turn before the round ends. And what do the seas have in store for her? Oh, look out, but she's on land, so she's okay. So first thing she's going to do, she's use one movement, and again, she's going to be facing off against this pirate here. So rolling initiative, and she misses. So, she got any rerolls? No, she doesn't. Okay, well, she will draw a card. She'll use this to draw a card. And that does not give her any rerolls either. So she needs five close to avoid capture. Unfortunately, she can't do that, so she will be captured. As she's captured, she moves back to the nearest pirate haven, which is this one here. Then she'd have to discard treasures, a crew card, and an elite card, but she doesn't have any to do that. However, her swagger does go back to the last green space here, so she's down to one. And she gets rid of all bloodshed tokens. And that's the end of her turn. She would have to draw up, but she has no cards in her deck. And it's then the end of round. Then, setting up for round two, we each take a new chaos card, so the old ones go away. And then we draw two territories and place a random sea token in each. So we've got Saint Vincent. So we get one there. And Campeche. Campeche? Campeche. So that's just there. And then we change who our first player in the round is going to be. So that will be Rogue, as she has the least swagger here. So Pixel starts round two with rolling. Hang on. It's chaos time.
You're a dead man, unless you can outrun my cannons. Attack a nation ship and suffer the consequences.
So, if a pirate attacks any sea token this turn, the crew gets lazy. Add plus two attack value to any encounter. If defeated, you get plus one reputation token. So, that's going to make life just a little bit harder for Rogue here. But she does still need to roll that sailing dice, so let's roll that. And she got treasure, but she's on land, so we can ignore it. And then she will move one, and again, try and fight her nemesis, this pirate here. Can she get initiative on it? No, she still can't. Okay, can she reroll? Can she reroll? Not currently. she'll draw another card. So she'll play this to draw a card in the hope that it'll give her a reroll. Which it does. So she will use that to reroll. And hey, she hit. So she has initiative. She needs to do five cannons or six close quarter. Oh no, it's okay, it's okay. She can just do it. So two cannons from Fire in the Hole, two cannons from Red Jolly, and one cannon. Oh, but the stupid card means it's got plus two, so she can't do it. Oh. Okay, so she's got initiative, she's running away. She does not want to be with this pirate anymore. She is running over here. That's one movement. Two movement even. So she has one movement left. Well, I think what she's going to do is she's going to join me in Nassau so that we can form a gang on my go. And she'll end her turn there. She's out of movement. So she needs to draw back up. She's only one card down. So she draws one more to get four. And it's over to me. And we're both together here, so we'll form a gang. So we still roll the sailing die. Now, only chaos card that will apply is if one comes out from this. Which it didn't, we get lookout, but we're on land, so we're safe. So we will go one, two, three. As we've got a gang, we'll take advantage and we're going to try and take out this fort here. Rolling initiative, we get a hit. So, as the primary player, I play my cards first. So I've got two close combat. So what do we actually need? We need 12 close combat, 11 ranged. So that's two. So that's one and five. I'll do two and two there. So that's three and seven. And I get a reputation token, which I'll immediately use for the powered up version of that. So that was seven and three plus three, so six and seven. Then that's me out of cards, so let's see if Rogue can make the rest. Well, she is also gonna play Scourge of the Seven Seas to get herself a reputation token. So that puts us to 8 and 9. She's then going to use the token to beef up, cut them to pieces, giving us 10 and 12. So we've got enough close combat. We just need one more cannons. And that's two more cannons. So that's enough. For beating it, we split 8 swagger, so 4 apiece. So Rogue is up to 5, and that takes me up to 11, which means I've leveled up. Then, because Rogue has the least swagger, she'll get a reputation token as well. And the token, it's the first fort destroyed, so it will go there. Meaning we bring out a new random fort, and it will appear in Bermuda. So for leveling up here, I now do better on the initiative dice, but I also get an advanced pirate card, which goes to the top of my deck. And then it's time for me to draw up Hand of Four, and it's over to Rogue. Because of forming a gang, Rogue only has one card in hand, so she needs to draw up, drawing three more cards. And then she can move on to rolling her sailing dice. And she can't form a gang even though we're together because we've already formed a gang this round. So she'll roll the dice. She gets treasure, but because we're on land, we ignore that. She'll then move one out to sea. And two to near Charleston here to see what we got. So got a pirate is initiative on her side. Oh yes, it is critical hit, so that'll give her plus three to either close combat or ranged attack. So she would only need two more close combat or three ranged, so she's gonna use Blow the Man Down to give her the two combat she needs, which along with the plus three for the crit means she wins. And the token gives her free swagger, so one, two, three, meaning she's leveled up. So she gains an epic pirate card. And the pirate ship token will join the enemies of the Pirate Republic. Then with her last bit of move, she's gonna sail one over to here, revealing a pirate. Two ranged or two close combat, so we need three of either. And it gives free swagger and a reputation token. So, is initiative on her side? Yes, so she's just leveled up to level two, meaning that the plus two side here is enough for her. So she does hit. And she just needs three of either. So she'll do free ranged using those two cards. And sinking another pirate. So that joins the enemies. So we've got three pirates there now. And she gains three swagger. One, two, three. Putting us both on 11 at the moment. And she gains a reputation token. Then she's out of move, so it's the end of her turn. She draws up to four cards. She's only got one left in her deck now, but it's now my go. But before my turn starts, I get interrupted with chaos. So the card is immediately read. Here is to a good hot fight. May the best dog be on top. I say too much wine. Women and dice. The crew breaks into a brawl. Generate two close quarter attack to quell the brawl. If not, take a bloodshed token. So, I'm actually going to have to use two cards to do this. So, I will use Cut 'em to Pieces and The Merry Short Life. So, that gives me the two close combat. And now I can roll the sailing dice. Oh, so I get a chaos card. So this goes to rogue, and my movement is reduced by one. So that limits my options, because I'll move one to open sea, then the only things I can reach are these, really. I'd rather take out the merchant, but I don't have the cards to do that right now. So I guess what I'll do is I'll play Jolly, Red Jolly, to draw a card, which has not helped me in one bit. So the only thing I can successfully do is go one and try and take out this pirate here. So let's see, is initiative on my side? No, critical miss. Don't have any rerolls, so I've got to defend, and he has plus three. So he has five. Well, I can use grappling hooks to give me four, so that I'm only taking a bloodshed token and not being captured. And then having defended, I now have the initiative to attack or run away. I can't actually beat him, so I will run away to the great little pirate haven here. And then I draw up, so back to four cards, and back to rogue. Doesn't need to draw up, so sailing dice it is. Oh, she hit a ship, so that's not a good sign. Kind of fitting with the fact that she got lookout. So there are no navies or pirate hunters on the board yet, so they're not going to move. Instead, she gets a random token that is a pirate. She's got the opportunity to run away if she wishes, or she can try and stay and fight it. And she's going to choose to move away, moving into this pirate haven at Ogarekchok, or however that's pronounced. And as she's there, she'll spend a reputation token to claim the pirate haven. Which completes her mission. Make a pirate haven on Urukuk. So she's done that. So she gets one swagger, taking her to 12. So the options she now has is to move back out to sea and face the pirate that she just ran away from, which she can't actually defeat it. So she's going to play this to get a reputation token. And she'll also play You Miss Me Bow to get a reputation token. And then she's going to just... Oh, no, I see what she can do. She's going to spend one of those reputation tokens to shuffle up to two discarded cards back into her deck, and she will then stop. She's got one card left in hand, and because of playing that, she has just enough to draw back up to four, so it's not quite end of round yet. So I don't need to draw up, so sailing, well, I've got plus three, so six movement, so plenty of movement. So I'm going to start by sailing out to sea and encountering a pirate. And let's see, initiative on my side, nope, critical miss again. Do I have a reroll? Because that's a pretty big issue. No, I have no rerolls. So I need to defend against five again. Well, I'll play that and draw a card. That might make the difference. Oh, it does. I've got a reroll, so I will reroll. Oh, hit. Okay, so I've got the initiative, I only need three of either, so I'll play those two that will give me free ranged combat, which will take out this pirate. Taking me to 14 swagger, giving me a reputation token, and adding the pirate to there, so we're up to four pirates now. And then I've only used one out of my six movement. So I'll use one to go there, then two to go into Nassau. I'll spend a reputation to look at two captain missions. So we've got select successfully scout a treasure fleet, and establish a pirate haven on Pensacola. I think that one's too difficult because it's hard to get to. It means taking over land, so I'm going to put that one away. But I'll keep the successfully scout one. I think I can manage that. And I still have movement left. I've only used three out of six. So what I'll do is I'll go one, two, three, and scout out to Touga here. So we have a port, 5 or 5, so not too bad. But obviously with my one card left, I'm not going to be able to take it on. So I will retreat rather than attack. And that's then my go over. And I need to draw cards, but I am out. So it is the end of round. Because Rogue went first, that is the end of round. It's not even just last go of the round, it is end of round. So, set up for round three, we get a new Chaos card each. And then we draw two territories per player, so four territories. And we place in the first two Navy ships, so Barbados, which is down the bottom there, gets a Navy ship, and Williamsburg, which is right up the top here, oh, very close, gets a Navy ship. Then Dominica gets just a random ship, so there we go. And that one gets a random ship too. So we're all set up. Lowest swagger is still Rogue, so she will be starting the round. So she rolls her sailing dice and she gets plus three. So six movement. And she's going to have to start by going out to sea, and then for fighting this pirate, what does she get? She gets a miss. If she was level 4, it would be a hit, but for her, it's a miss. So, she got any rerolls? Yeah, she will use Yamis Mibao with a reputation token to get a reroll and two cannons. Oh, and then a critical hit. So, worth the reroll. So that means she's already got five cannons. She needs one more cannon to win. So she'll use Fire in the Hole to give her two cannons, which is enough to win. Taking her to 15 swagger. And that's then our fifth pirate. One more, and we're going to lose Havens. Then she'll go 1, 2, 3 down the coast. So that's four of her movements so far to fight this merchant here. And is luck on her side? No, critical miss. She doesn't have any rerolls. She has a draw card, so she will draw a card. Nope, she gets a reroll. Nope, she doesn't. So she has to defend against six cannons. Well, she'll use Scourge of the Seven Seas. We'll give her two and a reputation token that she can then use with this for free. So that'll give her five cannons. So that at least then means she's not captured, she's just bloodshed. And she has no cards left, so she can't really fight back. So she's just gonna retreat. And she'll retreat over here, and then with the remaining movement, go into Nassau. So she draws back up, and it's my go. And I roll the sailing die. And I get plus two movement. Well, this port looks kind of vulnerable here. Yeah, I'm going to try and take on this port, I think. So let's roll initiative. Critical hit. That's a good start. So I only need three of either close or ranged combat. Okay, so I'll play Fire in the Hole and Red Jolly to give me four, which with my three for the critical hit is enough to take out the port. So for taking out this port, I gain three swagger, so taking me to 17. I gain a reputation token, and I gain a chaos card, which of course goes to Rogue. And triggers immediately. Aye aye, in mercy's name. Find us some fish bait if you can. Destroy any ship this turn. Place three discarded cards of your choice back into your hand. So, if I can destroy a ship as well, then that'll do me well. And of course, the port is the first port destroyed, goes in there, meaning we get a pirate hunter out. And here we'll go in Great Apacole. I now have two pirate republics, so my fleet size increases by one. So I draw a random sea token, and I get five cannon and five close combat. Very nice. I'm gonna go 1, 2, so that's three movement total so far, and we find a nice easy merchant, but is luck on my side? Well, it's a hit because I'm over level 2. I need to do three cannons, so I will attack with my new fleet ship here, which will easily destroy the merchant, which gives me just the one swagger and is our fourth merchant destroyed. So we need two more before that triggers. I'm then going to use what's left of my movement to go 1, 2 into Nassau to be with Rogue here so that we can have a gang next time. And I've only got two cards, so I draw up to 4. And it's over to Rogue, who has 4 cards in hand. We will form a gang and then roll the sailing dice. Red lookout is nothing because we're in Nassau. So first thing we do is we go 1, then 2. So we need to roll our fighting dice for this merchant here. And we get a hit. So Rogue playing cards first. Well, as you can see that I've got the fleet that can easily take it out. She's not going to play anything. So my fleet will take out the merchant. And Rogue will take the swagger token as the reward. And that's our 5th merchant now, so still not enough to trigger anything. We've done 2 move. And then our 3rd move will be into Williamsburg here. So we're then up against this British Navy. So rolling initiative, we get a critical hit. So that's a good start. That's 3 in 1 thing. And we need 9 and 10, but we know we've got 5 and 5 from my merchant here. So we only need 4 and 5 from cards. Well, the best thing she can do is use reputation token and play this to give us 2 and 3, and nothing else will really help. So she will do that, giving us 2 and 3. Then it's over to me, so I use my merchant here, so that puts us to 7 and 8 of the 9 and 10 we need. I'll then play Scourge of the Seven Seas. So that puts us to 9 and 10, which is exactly what we need, and I get a reputation token. So we have defeated the British Navy, which, because that was one of our objectives, so that's half the objectives completed, that goes on the objective card, but we do still get the rewards, which is 2 swagger each, putting Rogue to 17 and me to 20, which is enough to level up. So my hand size increases by 1, and I get a crew card, which will be added to the top of my deck. And it's a very nice crew card it is. I then get a reputation token, and Rogue will get 2 because she has the least swagger. And then Rogue gets a crew card, and her crew card is a freed slave, which gives nice benefits there. And we're out of movement for our gang, so that's the end of Rogue's turn. So she draws 1 new card, which is her crew card, so it sits face up in front of her, but does count towards her hand size. Then my turn, and I draw up because I've only got 3 cards. My hand size is now 5, so I draw 2. The crew card sits face up and stays there. So, rolling the sailing dice. Ooh, red. So, the nearest pirate hunter or navy, it's this pirate hunter. He's going to come and he's going to attack me. So, I need 12 and 11. And who has the initiative? Oh, I do. Oh, that's so lucky. Oh. So I need 12 and 11. Well, my ship gives me 5 and 5. My crewman gives me 2 and 2. So that is 7 and 7. Then cards from my hand. Well, I'll play that to draw a card. And that was a good move because I got the 13 gun salute. So that puts me up to 8 and 10. Then I'll use Try Again Matey with a reputation token. So that's 9. And it allows me to draw a card. So we've got 9 and 10. I'll use this beefed up with a reputation token. Give me another 2 and 3. So that's 11 and 13. So I've got enough close combat. I just need one more cannon, which I can get from Strike Your Colours. So that's enough to defeat the Pirate Hunter. Giving me a reputation token, 5 more swagger, taking me to 25. And then I'll go 1, 2, and 3 into Nassau. And that's my go over. I draw back up because I've got the crewman and one card left in hand. I just draw 3 more cards. And it's Rogue's turn. Her hand is full, so she'll start just by rolling sailing die, and she gets a new chaos card. And it doesn't trigger yet. And her movement's reduced by 1. So, I think she's just gonna go. She's gonna go into Williamsburg here. And let's see what we find. We have a port, which is a bit rich for her blood, with 5 cannons and 6 close combat. So she's going to come back out, and that's her done, I think. Oh no, she'll play Splice the Main Brace to rest, which will allow her to remove her bloodshed token. And then she draws up, and it's my go. So, rolling the sailing die. Oh, I knocked myself over. I get +2 movement, which may be useful. First thing I'll do is go 1 to open sea, then 2 to where this merchant ship is, and then let's roll initiative. So I'm level 2 or more, so I get a hit. And I can just take it out using my merchant ship. So that just gives me 1 swagger, taking me to 26. But more importantly, it's the 6 merchant ship. So we bring out a navy ship per player. So first one in Key Biscayne. So right next door. And ooh, it is what we need. Penico is the red cross on the white, I think. It's over here, Penico, yeah. Red cross on the white, red cross on the white. So if we can take out that navy ship, we win. And the other one is in Acapulco. Going down to Acapulco, and it's a British one. Okay, so it's still my go. I've used 2 movement out of 5. So I'm gonna, can I take out this ship? I think I might be able to. It's only got, we'll give it a go. So, 3rd movement. Let's try and take out this navy ship here. That's the wrong dice to be rolling. Oh, miss. That's not a good start. That's not a good start at all. And I've got no reroll. I've got no rerolls. So I am defending against 8 and 9. I am being captured. I have been captured. So I go to the nearest pirate haven, which is just there. I lose my crew card. I lose an advanced pirate card. Don't have any treasure cards to lose. Oh, well, that was painful. So, that ends my turn. And in fact, because of losing the crew card, I would need to draw up, but I've got no cards in hand. Oh, and I forgot to reduce my swagger back down to 20. But I'm still level 3, I still have the increased hand size, so I need to draw up, but I can't, which means it's end of round. And Rogue went first, so that is end of round. Oh no, we lost. If that dice had just come out differently. Okay, that's the game. And that is The Pirate Republic by Greenfeet Games. I do hope you've enjoyed this video. If you have, please do check out the rest of the videos on the channel, as well as sharing and subscribing to the channel. And as always, thanks for watching, and bye for now.